Hello everyone, welcome to another Berger Group video blog. Okay, so the market's up, right? Or did I hear that it's about to tank again? Every day we're bombarded with information about the housing market. Most of what you hear needs to be dissected. Did the information come from the national news, state, or was it local? From there, you need to figure out who is presenting the information and what is their motivation. You know, what's happened to much of the news these days, if you don't have a little drama to it, it probably won't make it on air. A couple of years back, our Association of Realtors, they were promoting that sales were increasing rapidly. What they didn't say was 72% of those were foreclosures. That doesn't mean much for you or me. By the way, we're standing inside of one of my lovely listings here. If you like what you see, please check out our website and find out more information. So here's the facts. In Kent County, there have been 9,134 home sales compared to 8,348 last year, for an increase of over 9%. Foreclosures representing about 16% of all sales. The median home sale price was $125,000 compared to $111,000 of last year, up about 12.5%. Here's where it gets interesting. This must mean that your home value went up 12.5% then, right? Not really, because the median sale price for foreclosure was $59,000, much less than the normal market. There were about 500 less of those types of homes sold this year than last. So by virtue of simply removing these super low-end homes from the equation, it bumps up our median home value. So yes, home values are rising, but there's always more to the story. I'm going to cover this a little bit more in a minute. Okay. The days on market before a home sells was 62 days this year, 90 days in 2012, for an increase of about 30%. The most expensive home sold was $1,715,000 compared to $1,495,000 last year. The least expensive home sold this year was $925. Last year, $1. Now let's break this down even further. If you're in a city area, you most likely haven't seen as much improvement as in the suburbs, mostly because there's still more foreclosures pulling values down there. Also, you become more of a commodity. There are more homes similar to you that aren't very far away from your location. If you have a home that you just can't find down the street and is in great condition, you'll have a better chance at getting more money for your home and exceeding the averages. If your home's in poor condition, dated, lacks amenities that buyers are looking for in today's market, you'll be below the averages. So, is the market up or is it down? It depends on your particular situation. For your own personal market evaluation, please give me a call or visit my website and fill out a free online home evaluation form. Thanks again for joining me, and make sure to sign up at my website for our next video blog, where we'll be talking about how property taxes work and how to save money by getting them lowered.